You are a demon hunter and on a quest to conquer demons. Along the way, you'll discover that you cannot do this alone. Other demon hunters belittle your abilities. Will you successfully conquer demons and face the strongest of them all? This is Journey to the West, Conquering the Demons. The film begins with Sheng talking with her fisherman father about scary sea monsters terrorizing the riverbank town. Suddenly, Sheng's father struggles underwater because a sea monster catches him, but oblivious, Sheng continues laughing. Sheng's father dies, and his blood mixes with the water while the villagers pull Sheng away from the riverbank. After the terrifying incident, the villagers summon a Taoist priest, hoping to kill the sea monster. The Taoist priest begins with a ritual prayer, dances with the wind, then drops a grenade into the river, killing a giant stingray. The Taoist priest announces that the monster terrorizing has already been killed. Suddenly, a homely man interrupts the villagers' celebration, disagreeing with the Taoist priest. He introduces himself as Chen Xuanzong, a Buddhist monk and demon hunter. Xuanzong claims that the stingray they caught is innocent, and the real demon is still in the water. The Taoist priest immediately cuts him off and acts offended, getting everyone's empathy. Xuanzong's words infuriated the villagers, so they tied him to a pole. Some of them dive into the riverbank and enjoy their freedom. Meanwhile, Xuanzong sees the sea monster from afar and quickly informs the villagers about it. However, they ignore his warning and continue to celebrate while it speedily swims towards them, eating a middle-aged woman. The townspeople scream in horror and quickly go out of the water. Xuanzong looks at the sea monster swimming beneath him and frees himself. Sheng, who is sitting on the wooden bridge, hears her mother's voice, gets up, and noisily runs towards her, catching the attention of the sea monster. The sea monster grabs Sheng from behind and drags her across the bridge. The mother quickly runs to her daughter and holds her feet, trying to stop the sea monster. The villagers help the woman by cutting off the sea monster's tongue, freeing Sheng, but she falls from the bridge. The mother instantly grabs Sheng's hand and tries to calm her when the sea monster unexpectedly emerges from the water and snatches Sheng away. The mother cannot move from shock but immediately dives in with a weapon in hopes of saving Sheng. The mother provokes the sea monster, and when it suddenly reveals itself, it horrifies her. She pleads to free Sheng, but it instead eats her. The sea monster swims after eating the mother and intentionally breaks the wooden bridge, causing a baby to fall off its mother's hands. It slides down towards the riverbank, but Xuanzong thumps onto the wooden bridge. Xuanzong pulls down the Taoist priest and holds onto him while he saves the baby just in time before the sea monster eats it. He tosses the baby up where it hangs while he watches in fear, seeing the sea monster preparing to attack again. Xuanzong climbs to the baby's location and carries it when the sea monster rises again and attacks both of them. Luckily, he dodges the attack, saving the baby for the third time. Meanwhile, the sea monster lies onto the wooden bridge, gasping for air. While upstairs, Xuanzong spots the Taoist priest, grabs him, and pushes him to bounce on the bridge to get the sea monster jouncing on the dock. The fishermen voluntarily jump to the bridge, but their weight is insufficient to get the sea monster to bounce to the dock. However, a heavy and stout woman comes out and jumps to the bridge, successfully bringing the sea monster to the pier. Suddenly, the sea monster transforms into a naked handsome man. Xuanzong takes out his tools and sings to the sea monster using the 300 nursery rhymes to unleash its goodness. However, the demon remains undaunted and hits him when a beautiful lady suddenly steps in and beats the monster to death before capturing it into her magic bag, turning it into a toy. The lady laughs at Xuanzong for using a kid's book to cast evil, while the villagers praise her for defeating the sea monster. Xuanzong leaves and returns to his master with a heavy heart, disclosing his failure to capture the sea monster. Xuanzong cries to his master's arms, doubting himself as a disciple of Buddha, but his master tells him that he is wrong in just missing a little something. He says that only when he attains enlightenment will he understand him and nursery rhyme's power. Then, he leaves Xuanzong to continue his mission. Meanwhile, in the middle of the wilderness, a couple walks towards a unique yet creepy-looking restaurant. Suddenly, an older man comes out of nowhere and enthusiastically welcomes them to the Gao Family Inn. Later on, they both eat the restaurant's delicacy. Suddenly, the waiter interrupts them. He reveals a young-looking yet strange man whose face is shimmering. Suddenly, he opens his mouth wide open, howling at them. The couple see the candelabrum is made of sharp steel and the roast pig by human flesh. The couple screams while Kale Hog gets the steel candelabrum and whips it towards them. Shortly after, while Xuanzong is traveling in the forest, he accidentally sees the restaurant. After getting inside, Xuanzang's eyes widen in horror as he sees the candelabrum made of steel, the customer's bloody corpses, and the people inside of the rotisserie. He discloses his true purpose and instructs the waitress to reveal herself. The waitress acts innocent at first, but when he punches her face, the waitress furiously attacks Xuanzang with a forefinger when the gorgeous lady hunter stops her and beats her to death, turning her body into specks of dust. Then when the remaining demons attack her all at once, she uses her unique bracelet, it kills all the monsters one by one. After finishing the last demon server, the lady taunts Kale Hog to come out while he quietly sneaks behind her. The lady senses his presence and aggressively attacks Kale Hog, engaging in a violent fight. The lady holds his arms behind his back and calls Xuanzang to help her to get Kale Hog's essence from his throat. Xuanzang successfully sucks the pig's essence, but his body turns blue, and he struggles to breathe. The lady quickly kisses him, transferring the spirit and pain to her. But she endures the pain and breathes it into her magic bag to trap him. However, Kale Hog refuses to be trapped and aggressively frees himself by turning into a wild boar. The lady grabs Xuanzang out of the restaurant as it crumbles into pieces. They run to the river inside the forest to escape Kale Hog. After treating her wounds, the lady introduces herself as Duan while Xuanzang thanks her for saving his life. Suddenly, she closes her eyes, which confuses him. The women close their eyes because they want a kiss. Shocked by her words, Xuanzang runs off without saying anything. The morning after, Xuanzang returns to his master, who teases him about his encounter with Duan. Once again, Xuanzang doubts his abilities. His master then tells him to find the Monkey King, who Buddha imprisoned under the Five Finger Mountains for 500 years. Before leaving, his master advises him to be careful with the Monkey King as he is tricky, evil, and full of hatred. That night while walking in the forest, Xuanzang accidentally steps into a trap and gets hung upside down. Then, a chariot appears carrying a group of demon hunters. The boy frees him and commands his members to reveal their prisoners. Xuanzang is confused to see Duan in them while the woman informs him that they are demon hunters. Duan tries to help him but suddenly realizes she has made a mistake when her hands freely hold Xuanzang. Xuanzang realizes that all of it was a ruse of Duan to wear him down. However, she insists that she has found the man of her dreams with him. Xuanzang resists, so Duan imprisons him inside the chariot. Fed up by Duan's actions, Xuanzang tries to leave when suddenly they hear a noise. They immediately prepare themselves when Kale Hog comes out from the bushes. They rapidly hammer the sack to move the chariot while Kale Hog chases them. Kale Hog advances to the front and runs towards the chariot. Xuanzang gets up and walks towards the unconscious Duan. However, Kale Hog ruins their moment and prepares to attack them. When a tiger roars and attacks him out of the blue. Then it changes into a praying mantis. And prepares to attack again, but Kale Hog runs off, and an older man engages in a fight with the mantis. He is called the Fist of the North Star while the other is named Almighty Foot. Suddenly, a sword comes out of nowhere, another demon hunter, Prince Important. While the three interferers argue about the best demon hunter. Duan pleads with Xuanzang to leave her with some dignity, but anger clouds his mind, so she tears the book into pieces, beats him, and belittles his abilities. Then she moves on to Prince Important to recover from embarrassment, while Xuanzang goes without a word. Following that, Xuanzang returns to finding the Monkey King. He successfully finds the old temple but only sees rock mountains. Devastated, he sits in front of the temple, imagines the mountains like the water reflection mirror, and finally sees the Buddha statue. Xuanzang climbs the rocks and finds a spot full of leaves and a lotus. He sees a cave inside of a stone and jumps inside of it. Sun Wukong introduces himself as the Monkey King, so Xuanzang respectfully bows at him. Sun Wukong informs Xuanzang about his real story, how he became a human trapped inside the cave because of a disagreement with Buddha. However, Xuanzang cuts him off and asks how to defeat Kale Hog, alias Pig Demon. He then tries to get out of the hole but stems come out, stopping him. Sun Wukong cries in frustration and pain. He tells Xuanzang needs to do, find a pretty girl to sing and dance the love song to moonlight, and Kale Hog will show up. Suddenly, Duan hears their conversation and volunteers herself to be the bait. Later on, Duan dances and sings in the moonlight while Xuanzang plays the music. Suddenly, Kale Hog comes out. Sun Wukong calls Kale Hog, so he looks into the cave and sees Sun Wukong. He tries to get out desperately but ends up falling into the cave. Duan turned him into a toy. After bidding his goodbye, Sun Wukong interrupts his thoughts and asks to see the full moon. Xuanzang breaks the lotus blocking the view when it suddenly lights itself in a fire. He tosses the lotus to the leaves, creating a pit fire. Sun Wukong laughs maniacally as he finally tricked Xuanzang. Sun Wukong finally gets out of the cave and is back on his proper form. Then, Xuanzang starts to pray to Buddha, and the Monkey King threatens him. The Monkey King angrily plucks out his hair while he prays through the pain. Suddenly, Prince Important, Almighty Foot, and Fist of the North Star stop the Monkey King from killing Xuanzang. Fist of the North Star attacks the Monkey King first, but he fails abysmally from the start without much fight. Almighty Foot then jumps up to the rocks and releases his gigantic right foot and whips it towards the Monkey King, but it is not enough. The Monkey King defeats another demon hunter again. Then, Prince Important opens up his weapon. He flicks one towards the Monkey King, and it becomes a steel sword. The Monkey King dodges it and holds it, but it drags him out of the ground. Facing the three demon hunters, the Monkey King thanks them for a fun fight and then loudly roars, turning them into ashes. He comes back to Xuanzang, still kneeling, and tries to kill him, but Duan stops him. She angrily attacks the Monkey King with her bracelet, but it hits him like a wind. The Monkey King mercilessly claps his hands, her head in between, causing damage to her. With her last breath, Duan finally hears Xuanzang confessing his love to her. He carries her into his arms, crying in agony as he kisses her. The Monkey King taunts Xuanzang for killing Duan and for believing in Buddha. Then, he sees his nursery rhyme book that Duan fixed before. Suddenly, Xuanzang's appearance changes. It turns out that Duan turned it into the Buddha Sutra instead of the nursery rhymes, and he murmurs words as he reads the sutra. The place starts to shake, revealing a massive statue of Buddha. The Monkey King flies up to the figure and breaks it in half. But then, a colossal figure of Buddha from space comes out, angering the Monkey King. Buddha uses his one hand to defeat the Monkey King, but he changes his form into a gorilla and angrily roars at the hand coming to him. With all his might, the Monkey King lifts the hand, but it is too strong. Instead of death, the Monkey King is suddenly at a peaceful field of grass. But Xuanzang comes out and gives him the infinite flying ring. With no words, the Monkey King knew that he had reached enlightenment. Following that, Xuanzang returns to his master, where he finally realizes that love is neither greater or lesser. His master gives him his holy robe and ritual items and lets the sea monster, Kale Hog, and the Monkey King go with him on his journey to continue defeating monsters and demons. The movie ends with Xuanzang becoming a disciple of Buddha and continuing his mission with the three demons he encountered. Suddenly, Xuanzang sees an apparition of Duan's face in the clouds and smiles because of her. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this.